In this video, we are going to study about the exterior angles and pairs of exterior alternate angles. You know that when two parallel lines are cut by a transversal, 8 angles are formed, out of which angle 1, angle 2, angle 7 and angle 8 get formed in the exterior of the region formed by these two parallel lines, line L and line M. So, angle 1, angle 2, angle 7 and angle 8 are called as exterior angles. Out of these four angles, we get two pairs of angles. First pair is of angle 1 and angle 7 and the second pair is of angle 2 and angle 8. These are called as pairs of exterior alternate angles. As you can see, angle 1 gets formed here and angle 7 gets formed here. Angle 1 and angle 7 are called as exterior alternate angles because they lie on opposite sides of the transversal T and in the exterior of the region formed by line L and line M. So, exterior alternate angles are such that they are on different sides of the transversal, alternately one on left side and the other on right side of the transversal. Also, one angle is above the upper parallel line L and the other below the lower parallel line M. Thus, both the angles in each pair are not between the parallel lines but are in the outside or exterior of the region formed by two parallel lines. Let us study the relationship between the measures of angle 1 and angle 7. Angle 1 measures 110 degrees, whereas angle 7 also measures 110 degrees. So, these angles have equal measures and we can say that angle 1 and angle 7 are congruent to each other. Now, if we see another pair of exterior alternate angles, angle 2 and angle 8, angle 2 gets formed here and angle 8 gets formed here. Angle 2 and angle 8 are formed on opposite sides of the transversal T but in the exterior of the region formed by line L and line M, as you can see here. If we measure angle 2, it is 70 degrees. Let's measure angle 8, it is 70 degrees. So, they are equal in measure, or we can say that angle 2 and angle 8 are congruent to each other. Now, we can say that when a transversal cuts two parallel lines, we get two pairs of exterior alternate angles, such that in each pair, the measures of the angles are equal. Or in other words, each pair of exterior alternate angles is of congruent angles. Then what is the relationship between the angles in each pair of exterior alternate angles? When they are formed by two intersecting lines and a transversal? Let us see. You can see line L and line M are two intersecting lines cut by transversal T. You know that we get two pairs of exterior alternate angles. Angle 1 and angle 7 form first pair and angle 2 and angle 8 form the second pair. Let us measure angles in the first pair. Angle 1 measures 140 degrees. Angle 7 measures 110 degrees. Similarly, angle 2 is 40 degrees and angle 8 is 70 degrees. Now we can say that when a transversal cuts two intersecting lines, we get two pairs of exterior alternate angles. But if we look at the measures of angles in each pair, there is no specific relationship between them. Whereas in case of parallel lines, we have seen that each pair of exterior alternate angles is of congruent angles. So that brings us to a conclusion that if a transversal intersects two coplanar lines and each pair of exterior alternate angles is congruent, then those two lines are parallel. Well, if we have more than two parallel lines intersected by a transversal, how many pairs of exterior alternate angles will be formed? Will these pairs also be of congruent angles? And what if we have more than two parallel lines intersected by more than one transversal? Try it out.